Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nidja, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm going to render exposition of John 13, verse 1 to 20. Jesus washes the disciples' feet. Now the word disciple, as I told you, is wrong. Washes the laborers. They were, you know, the friends of Jesus. So they were no more laborers but friends. As you have friend, you know, when you marry, you have a girl, and when you marry her, then she becomes your bosom's friend. So Jesus wanted to perform that marriage, which is mentioned in the parable of the marriage of the son. So a certain king wanted to marry his son, and then all that, you know. So here Jesus was going to marry the virgin brides. Jesus is the bridegroom. So he washes their feet to welcome them into the house of our Father. Now, into this house of our Father, a person who loves mammon is not welcomed. So that's why Jesus threw Judas Iscariot out, because he was a thief. And these hireling dog-collar priests are in the same shoes as Judas Iscariot. They are thieves, you know, not worthy into the house of our Father. They are hypocrites. So you have to be careful. Now, before the feast of the Passover, when Jesus knew that his hour had come to depart out of this world to the Father, that means on last day, you know, having loved his own who were in the world, loved his own me, the people who were predestined of our Father, he loved them to the end. During supper, when the devil had already put it into the heart of Judas Iscariot, Simon's son, to betray him, Jesus knew that the Father had given all things into his hands, and that he had come from God and was going back to God, our Father, rose from supper. He laid aside his outer garments and, taking a towel, tied it around his waist. Now, before he started to wash their feet, Judas Iscariot had been thrown out because he was not welcome into the house of our Father. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the laborers, or we can say the bosom friends. So they were bosom friend, not disciple, you know. Feet. To wipe them with the towel that was wrapped around him. He came to Simon Peter. Simon Peter was the only laborer who was once born. He was the gatekeeper to the vineyard of our Father, who said to him, because he was once born, he addressed Jesus as Lord. Do you wash my feet? Jesus answered him. Do you want to wash my feet? Jesus answered him. What I am doing, you do not understand now. Simon Peter, he honored Jesus very much. As you honor a rabbi, You wash the feet of the rabbi. Rabbi doesn't wash your feet. So when Jesus came to him, he wanted to wash his feet. He said, "Do you want to wash my feet?" We were a bit surprised. Then Jesus told him, "You don't understand now, but afterward you will understand." Peter said to him, "You shall never wash my feet." He was so honoring Jesus, you know, as a rabbi, that he doesn't want him to wash his feet. But Jesus answered him, "If I do not wash you, you have no share with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Lord," that is what, you know, the once upon person will say, "not my feet only, but also my hands and my head. Hands, that I shall not do any bad thing. Head, that I always think gospel or think good things." Jesus said to him, "The one who has bathed does not need to wash." That you have already had taken bath, you know, does not need to wash except for his feet, but is completely clean. So, because he was bathed, is it John the Baptist baptism is the bathing. Bathing in the name of Abraham. So he was the sort of the Abraham, a righteous person, never tell lie, thinking good everything. So Jesus said, if you have been bathed in the baptism of John the Baptist, in the name of Abraham, so you are already a son of Abraham. So you do not need bathing of the body from me, but only the feet, which I want to honor you into the house of my Father. So that is the custom. You remember Jesus went to the house of the Simon, the Pharisee. And Pharisee Simon, he wanted to test Jesus, not to honor him. So he went there. He did not wash the feet of Jesus. But Mary Magdalene came and washed the feet of Jesus with tears of love, extreme love. And not of repentance that she is a sinner. She was not a sinner. This is a story made by the Messianic Jews. They have twisted the gospel, and so you have to be careful. So she wiped the feet of Jesus with her hair. Her hair means her own honor. She was very sensible, and she knew what she was doing. So Simon did not wash, he honored Jesus into his house, but that Mary Magdalene did. So here Jesus honored his bosom friends into the house of our Father by washing their feet. So, and you are clean, Jesus proclaimed to him. Clean, that means you don't tell lie, you are righteous person in the name of Abraham. But not every one of you. So he told him, not every one of you, mean Judas Iscariot, he was pointing out. For he knew who was to betray him. That was why he said, not all of you are clean. That means they were not truthful like this Peter. He was hypocrite. So hypocrite was not clean. So unless you become like little children, you cannot enter into the royal kingdom of God. While the others were his bosom friends, what is inside, they will tell him on the face. That's why when Jesus wanted to go to Judea region to raise Lazarus, His friends told him, "Don't you know they want to kill you? You want to die? You want to go there into that region? They are seeking to kill you." Jesus said, "No, I must go." Then all of them said, "We also will go with you and give our life for you." That is a bosom friend, you know. When he had washed their feet and put on his outer garments and resumed his place, he said to them, "Do you understand what I have done to you? You call me teacher and Lord." No, teacher, nobody called him. He was a preacher. Preacher is a spiritual of supernatural father. Teachers are the moral teachers like John the Baptist, Rabbi, Pharisee, Sadducee. So he was not a teacher. He was preacher of gospel. And he was not a Lord because he was our anointed elder brother. If he was Lord, he would keep the other people slave like Yahweh do. Yahweh is the Lord. He is jealous and revengeful. Jesus is not jealous and revengeful. He wants to uplift everyone. So he is our anointed elder brother. And you are right, for so I am. That's a, you know, corruption by the messianic Jews. So they can lord over the people and they can teach the New Testament in letters. So people would not question them, you know. They can quote this verse, you know, "Hey, look, it's written in the Bible that we are teachers and we are the Lord as Pope was Lord over the people." So it's a corruption, you know. And you should be careful of such corruptions in spirit. You can rectify them. "If I then, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet." Again, corruption, you know. We serve, you know, we serve people. We don't rule over them in the name of Jesus. So, "For I have given you an example that you also should do just as I have done to you." So all this is corruption, you know, by the messianic Jews. That is why, you know, these bishops and other things, they will ask the people, you know, to wash their feet, ladies and other things, and then immorality comes in. "Truly, truly, I say to you, a servant is not greater than his master." That means Jesus is the servant of our Father. So he is not greater than our Father. "Nor is a messenger greater than the one who sent him." That means our Father, you know. So Father is Father, Son is Son, but he had all the powers from Father. He was omnipotent ambassador of our Father. If you know these things, blessed are you if you do them. I'm not speaking of all of you. I know whom I chosen, but the scripture will be fulfilled. He picked up, you know, the remnant which God has given to him. Not by hip hazard. He knew which one are given to him. "He who ate my bread has lifted his heel against me." That means Jesus, he feeds the laborers, you know. They were eating his bread. Same, you know, somebody, you feed him, then he turn around and cheat you. So they are like Judas Iscariot. हेलो हाँ ना मैं देखना जरा क्या ठहर के करे अजय ओके हाँ चंगा हाँ ओके आई एम टेलिंग यू दिस नाउ बिफोर इट टेक्स प्लेस दैट व्हेन इट डज टेक प्लेस यू मे बिलीव दैट आई एम ही ट्रूली ट्रूली आई से टू यू हूएवर रिसीव द वन आई सेंड रिसीव मी एंड Whoever receives me, receives the one who sent me. Yeah, that's true, you know. And so here you are. I do this one and hope you will enjoy it. So there's a corruption in the New Testament. So you have to be careful once you know all the jigsaw puzzle. It's a jigsaw puzzle, you know. You fit in where the things come. If you know the corners of the jigsaw puzzle, then you can put the pieces at the right place. If there's something wrong, you can easily detect, you know, and rectify it. Gospel comes from your heart. And from your heart, when you understand it, then you lead the Bible. Bible does not lead you. Christians are led by the Bible, just the opposite. They don't know what they are saying. They vomit out what they read, like a novel. And like a novel, they vomit it out. Just make empty drums make a lot of noise. And by making a lot of noise, they impress upon people. Anybody who talks about sin, he is an antichrist. Because Jesus had nothing to do with sin. He is to do with blasphemy or hypocrisy. In Jesus, we expose hypocrisy. In John the Baptist or in rabbis, they found out the sin in the person and they punished him. So in Jesus, we expose hypocrisy. To tell people that these people are hypocrite and be careful of them. So what's happening in the Middle East is all known to us. These hypocrite politicians, they are there to please their paymasters, Mammon and media dominates in USA, UK and France. And that is in the hand of the Jews. So they are getting all that thing done in the Middle East. So that's why they are bundled up in Israel for final burning. Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30. Our Father God blesses you.